Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. In this video, we just going to see how to draw projection of lines inclined to both HP and VP. This problem is very very important. I will be explaining the question and then given data and what all things we need to find. I will be explaining and then I will start drawing the diagram step by step. The plan and elevation of a line. Plan means it will be denoting the top view. Elevation means front view. Are inclined at 35 degree, 50 degree. So 35 degree for top view and 50 degree for front view. That's what I have written here. Respectively to XY. One end of the line is touching both VP and HP. So one point. If the line is AB means A will be touching on HP and VP, and the other end is 50 mm above HP. So other end is B. B will be 50 mm above HP. Draw its projection, find its true length. So as usual, we'll be determining all the data. What are data we're going to determine is theta, phi, alpha, beta, front view, length of top view, and length of the true length. And finally, we'll be determining traces. First step is we're going to draw the reference line. The reference line is XY, and according to first order projection, vertical plane will be above and horizontal plane will be below. And first hint we going to use is they are clearly given that A is touching on HP and VP. So A means the first end of the line. So if it's touching HP means it's A dash. If it's touching VP means it's A. Since it's touching on HP and VP, the point will be lying on the reference line itself. This point holds good for A dash as well as A. The next hint is we going to use point B. The point B is 50 mm above HP. So from the reference line, the distance is 50 mm. From the reference line, you have to take 50 mm and draw a straight line. This line will be denoting the locus of B dash. Distance between these two lines is 50 mm. We know very well that B dash will be lying on this locus only. So we also have another end also, that is the front view is 50 degree. They are clearly given. So one end we got it. So for 50 degree. For 50 degree, if you draw a line, means that line will be meeting the locus of B dash, at one point, and that point is called B dash. So just take the hint of front view angle. So keep your protector at point A dash at this point. For 50 degree, you draw a line. For 50 degree, if you draw a line, means you will be getting like this. And this point is called as B dash. The next step is we can take the another end, that is top view is 35 degree. Keep your protractor upside down. Keep your protractor at point A. Keep it upside down. For 35 degree, you draw a line like this. For 35 degree, the angle is 35 degree. For 35 degree, you draw a line. We know very well that B and B dash will be lying on the same line. So try to extend this point vertically. So this line, vertical line, as well as for 35 degree, we took one line right. So if we are keeping a protractor and took 35 degree, this line will be meeting at one point, and that point, this point is called as B. And now we can easily draw the locus. Now we have fixed a point B right. Just draw a straight line, and this straight line is called locus of B. A and A dash will be lying on same line. B and B dash will be lying on same line. Now we have determined four locus. See here, this is the reference line as well as this line holds good for locus of A dash as well as locus of A. And we have locus of B dash and locus of B. So we have got four locus. Once we fix the four locus, it's very easy for us for complete the entire diagram. Now we are going to determine the true length. For that, we need to rotate either front view or top view. So in our case, take your compass, take a radius of A dash and B dash. Take your compass, take radius as A dash, B dash. Keep your compass at A dash and try to rotate an arc. If you rotate, means this arc will be cutting the locus of A dash at one point. So that point is called as B2 dash. When you rotate, the line will be cutting the locus of A dash at one point. That point is called as B2 dash. Then we need to extend this line vertically to the opposite locus. If it's A dash, means we have to extend till B. So extend this line vertically till locus of B. There you will be getting one point, and that point is called as B2. This point you will be getting at locus of B. So locus of B you will be getting one point at, that point is called B2. Now just join A and B2. A and B2 will be your true length. So whatever measurement you are having, that is your true length. Now same procedure we just going to do for top view also. Top view we are having a length, right? So AB, take your compass, measure radius as AB, keep your compass at A, try to rotate an arc. So you will be measuring here and you will be keeping the compass and you will be rotating in upward direction. When you rotate, the line will be cutting the locus of A. Locus of A at one point, and that point is called as B1. Since it's locus of A, we just going to extend this line vertically upward direction till it meets locus of B dash. So see to it that if it's locus of A means it has to be extended till locus of B dash. So extend this line till locus of B dash and name that point as B1 dash. If it's B1 means you have to name B1 dash. If it's B2 dash means you'll be naming it as B2. For front view, we'll be putting the dash. For top view, we won't put dash. And then finally, just join A dash. Just join this point and whatever point you got on locus of B dash. Join A dash and B1 dash. The length of this is your true length. So true length means A dash B1 dash equal to A dash B2. Both the length will be same for top and bottom. Now we are going to draw traces. For traces, follow the same procedure. Just have your reference for the previous video which I uploaded. In this case, it's little confusing. So hear my words carefully. First step is you need to extend A dash B dash. Extend A dash B dash. That line will be meeting the reference line at one point. Since we are having the same point, it will be lying on the same point itself. Extend A dash B dash. It will be meeting the reference line at one point. Mark that point as H. Since we are having same point, I just written close to it. Next step is extend your top view. Extend your top view AB to some extent till it meets the reference line. Same here also, it's lying on the same line. So we will be getting the point here itself. So that point is called as B. Next step is try to extend that point. H we got one point, right? Try to extend it vertically in such a way that it has to meet the top view. Where it meets the top view, that point is called as horizontal trace. In our case, everything lying on the same point itself. So we can just write horizontal trace nearby itself. Next thing is the point which you got vertical, right? When you extend vertically that B point which you got, it will be meeting the front view at one point. That point is called as vertical trace. See here, all the points are lying on the same reference axis itself. So we will be getting everything on this point itself. That's why I have just written nearby as vertical trace and horizontal trace. After completing the entire diagram, we have to go for dimensioning. So dimensioning, the first step is you need to put an extension line. So extension line should be very very thin, and you have to use the extension line for 2H pencil, and dimensioning line should be can be done with your H pencil. See to it your extension line should be perpendicular 90 degree. For example, if you are drawing your extension line for A dash B dash for your front view means the extension line should be perpendicular 90 degree for A dash B dash. As well as for AB also, the extension line should be perpendicular. For AB2 also same thing. Extension line use 2H pencil. Then for dimensioning line you can use H pencil. Draw the dimension line slanting. If the line is slanting means the dimensioning line should be parallel to that line. Same thing hold good for everything. So dimensioning line should be parallel to the whichever line you are drawing, and you have to break that line, measure the line with your scale and write whatever values you are getting. See to it that the number numerical should be written in vertical. The line can be slanting, but number should be written vertical as I shown here. Then you have to measure angle. These things we did in the beginning itself, but you have to dimension the angle in your diagram. So dimension as it is. So you will be getting for, if you are having a true length means you will be putting as a 45 degree. For front view 50 degree, for top view 35 degree, and for true length 25 degree. So these data are only there asking. So theta will be denoting your true length, alpha front view, phi is your true length, beta is your top view, and finally we have measured, right? We have already measured and wrote. For front view you are getting 66, for top view you are getting 53, and this is for true length. True length is same for both top and below. For A dash B1 dash and A B2 true length is same. And after completing this, you have to write like this in a tabular column. Heading height of the text should be 10 mm. The heading can be projection of lines. And finally, you have to write like all dimensions are in mm, scale 1:1 to the right bottom corner. And height of the text for this should be 5 mm. If you have any doubts in this, means you can write in the comment section. If you like this video, means you can share it with your first year students. And do subscribe my channel Mechanical Motivator. Then only you will be getting all the videos which I upload. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.